this phone lines is crazy. But running through these streets, I was just in the vicinity of, you know, the East Coast. And now we're going to the South real quick. You know what I'm saying? We're going to enter the South. And this is a good, surprising phone call right here. Young Buck, what's up, man?
What it do, homie?
What's up, God?
Man, good to be out. You understand me?
How long has it been, man? Like almost 2 years?
Man, it's been a minute, man.
Longer than 2 years?
Yeah, I've been at the penitentiary 90 days, but at the same time, for speaking to you, it's been a while, you know what I mean?
Yeah, man, that's crazy. Is there a difference coming back out with Tennessee or the music industry? Is there a difference? Or
of course, man, you know, things change every day, you know what I'm saying? I had a chance to keep up with whatever's dealing with as far as music goes, what's on the mainstream and things like that, and you know, I'm heavy, so I kept my ear to the streets in my own little ways throughout in the penitentiary. You know, we got our ways and doing things in there. So, you know, I was able to keep up with a lot of different music, you know, not as much as I am now that I'm out, but at the same time, I was hearing a lot of what's going on and just paying attention to what's on the TV. Things change, man. I feel like the rap game is a bit watered down, I should say, at this point, you know.
Did
everybody's happy and partying.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Everybody got Phantoms and everybody got Lambos and all this good shit, man. I'm like, damn, where's the hungry niggas at, man? Where's the struggle at, man? Who talks about the struggle? Because it's real out here, man, you know. So I think everybody's painting pictures right now.
I mean, those Tupac days is over, man. Like, everybody's, like, on some weird illusion that...
Man, everybody on some broke shit, but didn't want to make it look like they on some rich shit. That's what they on right now. You feel me? But in real life, you know what I'm saying? Niggas is feeling that goddamn hunger pain out here, and it's like, you know, they basically, to me, it's a lot of individuals in the rap game just following that, I'm already eating type role, other than really keeping it real with the fans and keeping it real with themselves. And you know, I come out determined to, and I've never been that artist to kind of ride the wave. I'm doing me. You understand what I'm saying? And it is what it is. I ain't sugarcoating shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm getting to it though in the real way, as far as out here in the streets, the same way I've been getting to it. So I'm just putting it into the music and letting motherfuckers know, look, man, this is the real deal. This is what's really going on. This is Buck. This is what Buck doing. Mm. I'm not knocking nobody else for what they got going on, because even the lie can win until the two hit him in the face. You know what I'm saying?
So yeah.
It is what it is, you know?
Especially you, because you went through hell with the streets and a lot of situations before you went in. So
yeah, it was a lot on me,
did you have to fix a lot of things before you came out or while you came out? Like a lot of the issues are fixed now?
I fixed a lot of my issues from the penitentiary, like as far as my bankruptcy situation. I paid my own bankruptcy off from the penitentiary. You understand? You know, the media can tangle and twist you in a lot of different ways. And my picture was being painted as if, oh, Buck is broke and Buck ain't got shit. But in reality, Buck been straight for a long time, you understand, even when I was going through my situation. Now, I will say, you know, I haven't been as up as I've been in my life, but I've never been down to the point where, you know, ain't no gas in the tank.
They were kind of like exaggerating with your video. They took your PlayStation, and I was like, come on, man, get the fuck out of here.
You know, even dealing with, like, speaking on those things, you know what I'm saying?
For, I was like, come on, man.
Stupid. The auction, the things they took out of my home, I had a chance to basically get all of the shit back. But I didn't want it all back because I had already bought it over again. So I'm like, you know, whatever shit that meant something to me, I bought back for us, the little jewelry and shit, my YB chain and the 615. Those little small things was monumental to me. And it's a little few more things in the middle. But the other shit, I told him, man, hey, man, keep that shit, man. I done bought that shit twice, man. Now, man, I'm a little bit heavier than the shit that y'all done sold, so y'all done me a favor.
I got a question, though. Did they ever take the crap table, that ill crap table you had in your basement?
They took it and I bought another one.
That was ill, man. You had some illegal gambling shit going on. That shit was gangster, man.
You feel me? See, like, you know how I get out. You know what I'm saying? You understand what I'm saying? So, you know, so like I say, some of the things that they did took, you know, I had to have. And the crap table was one of them, man. The crap table make more than me than some of these niggas making their whole year. You know what I'm saying? Doing music. My nigga, I make that shit in 24 hours, my nigga. You understand? Shit like that.
I got a question. In prison, you're a young buck. You still have the G unit, hologram behind you. Like, did you get people try to fuck with you or test you, or did you?
Man, I'm a real dude. So okay. I walk the yard and done my time just like anybody else. You know, it's a lot of people listening. I'm sure it's people tuned in at this point that may know individuals that done time with me. But I done mine in a real way, meaning that, I walk the yard. You understand what I'm saying? I hit the chow halls. You understand what I'm saying? I played the tickets, you know? I had plenty of stamps, and it take a motherfucker to be in the penitentiary to understand that language. But, you know, I've done my time like everybody else, man. And, you know, you for the most part, you're amongst me, and you understand you're amongst real niggas, and they respect that. You know, I didn't PC up like a lot of artists probably would being in that situation. I didn't go to a camp. I went to prison. You understand what I'm saying? I went to a real federal penitentiary. It wasn't no game. So, you know, far as the violence and things of that nature, you know, when you a real dude, real shit happened. And I had a couple little times where, you know, you got to get a little busy. You know, that's just a part of prison. You understand what I'm saying? So,
Yeah, that's crazy.
I done a little 6 months in the hole and shit like that.
Yeah.
23-hour lockdown, 24 hours on the weekends. You know, I done that for 6 months straight. I released a freestyle from the penitentiary, and I had said some shit like I fucked a couple COs to get shit in. I signed 2 autographs, 2 for the bitch friend, and they sent my ass right back to the hole on the investigation. You know what I mean? So, you know, I done like probably like a total of 9 months in the hole, man, just, you know, fucking around on some bullshit. But it is what it is, man. I had a lot of time to really get my mind together, and, you know, I don't suggest prison for nobody. That ain't a place for nobody.
Yeah. What rappers did stayed in contact with you when you were locked up? Anybody call you or keep tabs or write?
I spoke to 2 Chainz a lot, man. That's my brother. I got a lot of respect for 2 Chainz, man. He always checked in and made sure I was 100. You know, of course, Drummer Boy, man, that's my brother from another mother. You know, for the most part, those were the main 2 guys. I didn't really hear from nobody, you understand? I used to be tuned in when some of these motherfuckers would come across 106 Park like, God damn it, I know this nigga gonna holler Freak Buck or anything.
And nothing,
and
right?
Niggas, you know, a lot of niggas just, you know, I don't know if they forgot about me or I wasn't on their mind at the time, but, you know, I just didn't get that push from a lot of rappers, and it is what it is. I ain't got no ill will against a lot of these dudes out here that I've been amongst and shit like that. I just look at it as if, you know, I wouldn't, if I fuck with you, I fuck with you, meaning if you going through a situation, I'm gonna fuck with you from that situation. I ain't gonna fuck with you when you're up. I'm gonna fuck with you when you're down too, you understand, if I fuck with you. So, you know, at the same time, like I say, man, I didn't really get a lot of calls. My outlaw dudes, of course, you know, but they family, you understand? They stayed online with me. And Wendy Day, man. Wendy Day, I got a lot of love for her. She stayed in touch and kept me up to date, man, with as much as she could as far as what's going on and shit like that. You know, I used to speak with Big Meech a lot, you know, through the letters and things like that. Me and BG stayed in contact a lot, you know, and Boosie as well. So, and, you know, he's about to touch down, you know what I'm saying, and do his thing. So the dudes, a lot of dudes that I knew would be there, they were there, and that's as much as, you know, I'm happy with that. A lot of dudes that I thought would be there, you know, they wouldn't there, and that's cool too, you know what I'm saying, because I know now, and knowing is half the battle, you understand what I'm saying?
Well, you know, I've always, you know, respected you, Buck, and, you know, always, you know, I'm a pussy nigga, man. I'm not a gangster, you know what I'm saying? I don't know all this street shit, but musically, you know, I got you forever. And you're of course, you're, it's not just music, but you're like super homeboy. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Always been 100, man, from the beginning, man. Even throughout, you know, the situations, you always stayed neutral to the situation. Yeah. And I always had a lot of respect for you for that, man. And that's really what you know, got us right now at this point. You understand why I'm willing to do the interviews and fuck with you, because I know at the same time you've been a real dude from the beginning and you know, neutral and unbiased towards the situation, you know what I'm saying, that was there. And I just look at it as if, you know, I'm coming out of prison. I don't owe nobody shit. I don't owe no bankruptcy people, nothing. I don't owe no motherfucking time, you understand? I'm racked up out here in the real way. I'm getting it in these streets in the real way.
And you're free, right? You're free.
I'm not hurting for shit.
Yeah, you're free. You're free of everything. Free. Like,
I'm free of everything, you understand? I mean, all the way around the board.
Yeah.
Up into the music. So it's like, I'm looking to kind of start my thing over and get back at it, you know what I'm saying? In the real way, and let people know that, you know, you can go through things in life, but the things you go through in life make you who you are. And the shit that I done went through in life, it done made me a fucking animal. You understand?
Yeah.
What
yeah.
I'm
and speaking of,
from a music side of things,
speaking
man.
Of an animal, we might as well, because you are living dangerously, like right now. You're doing all these remixes, you're doing your freestyle and killing it, but I think we need to live dangerous, and we need to drop this joint right here, and we're going to come right back, man, because this right here is murder right here.
Man, yep. Go ahead and turn the streets up, man. Let me know, man. It's Young Buck, man. Ooh. I'm out here, man. Check in. Y'all tune in, my nigga. There's some real shit going Ooh. On right now. You might want to put me in your goddamn...
Shit, 45.
Your Google alert, nigga. You might want to put me in your Google alert.
Yeah. This is crazy Young right Buck. Here, man. Young Buck, Chris Webby, living dangerously. Let's go. Ooh, crazy. I was a... Yo, man, that is fucking ridiculous. Wow. Chris Webby, what's up, man? Dad, you did this record like fucking what? One hour? Like, I sent it to you and you just banged it out like pow.
That quick, man. Soon I seen that you was reaching out, I said, you know what, man, that's Whoo Kid, man. Let me go ahead and fuck with this ASAP. I told the engineer, man, just load that shit up.
Yeah,
it's probably the quickest record you ever got back in your life.
Huh? Hell yeah, man. It's fucking all these other Nas is still writing his verse. I'm like, Nas, man, fuck you, nigga. All your shit, man. It's gonna take it forever, man. And you did this shit in 30 fucking seconds, man. And I like the fact a lot of people don't know this about you. You have an ear for music. Like, you know how to mix shit. It's not just like you're just rhyming, you do the record, but you know, you even know how to mix the shit where it comes out even perfect. That's why I never even like question your shit. Oh, did you mix it? Is it the bass good? Blah, blah, blah. Like, how the fuck do you know this shit?
You know, I honestly feel Whoo Kid, I just ain't got my just due in this rap shit, man, by far, you understand? In reality, you know, a motherfucker look at me as a vet to this music shit, man, and it's like, okay, but that's only by the years that the Buck's been in it. You know, far as the material, in reality, man, I've only had 2 international albums, homie, and that's straight out of Cassville and Buck the World, and, you know, the situations took place far as, me and homeboy over there, and you know, it slowed everything down, and then I started going through all the different situations, and I was never able to even release, you know, a third album, and you know, from that point, it's a good and bad thing, because you know the success that came with my 2 solo projects, as well as the group albums that we've done over there, you know, it was enough to let the fans know that, you know, this nigga here is something serious. Mm. But at the same time, you know, I feel like I'm a freshman still in this shit, because I haven't really got to get to it the way that I want to get to it. And I would be a lie to sit here and tell you that ain't no interest. You know, my phone is going crazy. I got a lot of a lot of labels and shit that's trying to, you know, get me to come and have a meeting here, meeting there. You know, a couple big artists been stressed out as well, and you know, willing to fly me here and fly me there. And that's cool, too, you understand? But at the same time, you know, I'm the type of dude where, you know, it's a little bit more than just signing with a label. You understand what I'm saying? I require attention. You understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
From the things that I've been through, I would want to, you know, lay my hat where a motherfucker respect the fact of where I've been, but then also respect the fact of where I'm trying to go. So yeah, I'm not too quick to...
You want to be like you. You want to be comfortable in every aspect. It's not just, all right, I'm signing with this famous guy or famous company. No, you want to be comfortable. And then, you know, it's what's cool is even Baby just texted me when we were playing this shit. So, you know,
I mean,
come on, man.
Shout out to them too, man.
Yeah.
Baby, man.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm gonna keep it 100. I just now speaking on that, I left Baby out the loop because you know, I got the utmost respect for Baby, being that, you know, I came up under Baby, you know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm saying.
Me, Wayne, and Juvie, Kirk, and DG, you know, we all come from under Baby, you understand? I was a guy that was always there, but I wasn't, you know, in the mix for us, in the music, but I've been there since a child amongst Baby, and to be all the way 100 with you, you know, when I started experiencing going through my things that I went through, Baby was the first one to sit there like, hey, youngie, hey, what you need? You understand what I'm saying? Whatever it is, I'm going to take care of whatever it is. And, you know, I got just the utmost respect for him because even when I've been up, he's been there. When I've been down, he's been there. And, you know, he's just a real nigga. You understand? You don't get a lot of real niggas no more. You have a lot of motherfuckers that, portray to be real, but you know, being real is in your actions. It's not another motherfucker. It's not you saying you real. You know, let another motherfucker call you. Yeah, man.
Can you make it clear for these fans out there that's annoying me? This is not a G-Unit reunion comeback. You're doing your own shit. Make it clear. Make it very clear.
We definitely gonna be clear about that. You know, this is not a G-Unit reunion. It's not a G-Unit, me sign with G-Unit or none of that. It's just a real situation, you know, real dude just doing real things. And you know, speaking on yourself and me, you know, at the same time, we just, you know, you're a genuine dude, and I appreciate it and respect it. So you can stretch out and say, look, Buck, hey, let's push. I got this for you, you know. And at the same time, you know, that's what I need is a lot of genuine love and a lot of real dudes to push, you know, push with. And at the same time, it's not a G-Unit reunion by far, you know what I'm saying? I haven't even spoken with 15 years, you understand? And, you know, like I say, man, I wish him all the best, you know what I'm saying? I don't got no ill will in me and none of that shit. I was taught from the very beginning, you know what I'm saying? You can forgive, but don't forget. So, you know, anything that was done, not only just from, say, that side of things, but any individual that had any kind of negativity that came with them or without, I mean, with them or done anything dealing with Buck that was taken as a negative way, man, I forgive you. You understand what I'm saying? But I don't forget because I ain't perfect. You understand? And, you know, I've done a lot of things that fucked up and shit. I appreciate a motherfucker forgiving me. I don't want you to forget what I done.
Yeah, you used to be high and fucked up, talking crazy on stage.
And that's another thing, you know. I'm so clear, man. You understand? I'm out here on papers, you know.
Yeah.
In a real way. So, I got to walk down a straight lane. You understand what I'm saying? Because these them three-letter boys, they don't be bullshitting. You know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah.
They piss me every day. I tell them, here, man, you have it. Take it.
Yo, but Buck, this hip-hop shit, man, you can't really take it so serious, especially when the years go by and everybody's getting older. Like, you can't take all this, like, all these situations. Like for example, I saw, I'll give you one example. I saw Pistol Pete for New Year's Eve in a club. You know, he's with Fat Joe, the Big Pun thing. And yeah. that era where I, you know, everybody know I got kidnapped by Big Pun, and he knows that. But
yeah.
he came and said, what's up to me? But imagine like 8 years ago, he would have caught me and done something to me. I told him, the first thing I told him, I was like, yo, thank you for never like catching me and whatever, killing me or whatever. He started laughing and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like he started laughing.
Man.
Yeah, I was like,
he
yo.
Was so scary.
Yeah, I was like, yo, thank you for never catching me, and then you never killed me. But if you had done something to me, I probably wouldn't be who I am today. Then he just laughed his ass off. Like he was like, yo, who kid, yo, you're the craziest. But it's like, if you gotta think about it like that, like, are you really gonna take everything that goes on in hip hop serious? You see Lil Wayne and these guys battling, fuck you, fuck, can't take it serious anymore.
You and I both know, man, that you know. In the wave of you know, when the unit, you know what I'm saying, basically started doing their thing and moving, pushing, you know what I'm saying. It's real life. It was real life issues involved in it. And I come from these streets, man. You understand? And I understand what come along with the streets. So I've always judged situations as if this shit is for real. So, you know, that's why I had 10 niggas on the bus with gun license and ride like a fucking army. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Niggas know how I move. You understand it? Niggas know how I get down. And you one of them, you feel me? Because at the end of the day, yeah, for entertainment perception from some individuals, it may be taken upon as that. But some individuals take this shit real. And that's what I've done over these years, is like, because I know, you know, when I put myself in a position and I say fuck you, you know, I'm saying it in a real way, meaning I'm preparing myself for whatever come along with it. But I've just over the years learned that, you know, this business that we in, as far as this rap shit goes, man,
it's definitely not, you know, real.
Basically, you know what I'm saying?
And you can't mix street, you can't mix street with
fans,
yeah, you cannot, you cannot mix street with hip hop, because street is totally some real shit. Motherfuckers
right.
die. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But hip hop,
right.
you can't mix it. That's what I'm saying. You can't take what was happening in hip hop serious. It's not like you met the nigga in the street, y'all fucking shoot at each other, you fucked his wife.
Man.
Like, that's some real
mixing
shit.
Mixing the streets and hip hop, goddamn it, got me a attempted murder charge at the Vibe. Mixing the streets with hip hop sent me to the penitentiary, you understand, with a gun charge. You understand? Meeting the streets with hip hop, man, made me goddamn run up on a few rappers and shit.
Yeah.
You know, that we had issues with at the time and trying to see what it's really about. Is this for real, nigga? You know, because it's real with me. But like I say, man, the past is the past.
Mm.
And you know, I'm so focused on the future, man. I can't even take the time to look back at what was, especially if it's negative. I'm so focused on what it is and what I need to be, that's where my head is at, man. And it's like, you know, it's a good thing for a lot of these dudes that I look at things that way, because you know, I believe in getting active, my nigga, in a real way. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, speaking of getting active, have you ever, like, when you were locked up, you never called, like, you know, because Dr. Dre, they kind of owes you for a situation. He never thought of calling Dre for that O, whatever he owes you.
I've always thought of calling Dre and thought of calling Eminem. But let me tell you something, man. These dudes are at the top of the motherfucking food chain.
Yeah.
And in a sense, I'm at the bottom of the food chain, especially in prison. You understand what I'm saying? Getting in touch with these dudes is damn near impossible when you out of prison in the streets. You know what I'm saying? But, Dre is, to me, is the best producer in the world. You know, and Eminem to me is one of the best lyricists that's ever done this shit. Mm. And I got the utmost respect for both of them dudes. And even to this day, man, I'm open to have a conversation with either one of them. I definitely want to speak to Dre.
Mm.
You know, for a fact, I got a lot of respect for him because he was there for me throughout my situation. You know, as far as the bullshit when it went down, he ensured that you know, everything was 100. You know,
wow.
Like a boss do. You feel me? So Snoop. You understand? I can't forget Snoop because he's always been there. That's Unc. You understand? That's the homeboy. And
damn.
I spoke to him off the rip, you know what I'm saying, coming out of prison, him and Daz Dillinger, you know, they definitely stressed out to me and shit like that, you know. And my big homeboy on the West Coast, Big U, you understand, nigga,
oh, wow.
I get down and shit like that. So he's always been there. So, you know, that whole West Coast wave, you know, my family, I got a lot of family out there, you understand. And, you know, so they stay in the loop. Me and Game had a chance to touch bases. He came through my home city. He come down here in Cavesville.
Oh, wow.
And, yeah, man, he came down here and done a little situation with a show and shit. And at the same time, he was a real dude for stretching out, like, let's get together and make see what we can come up with. We went in the studio. We came up with some real shit. And at the same time, you know what I mean, we just kind of really work out the politics of it all. But,
that's crazy.
You know what I'm saying? We end up doing the record, and that motherfucker's a smash. I can't see him in front. You feel okay. What I'm saying?
It's DJ Whoo Kid, the Hollywood Shuffle.
Everybody's on my show. Actors, strippers, sports stars, comedians.
A-list only. I don't interview losers. Non-stop action, non-stop moisture.
You'll be laughing. You'll be peeing on yourself.
Get wet.
Every Saturday, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. Eastern Time on Shade 45, Sirius XM.
About this shit, so, you know,
your other homeboy Jeezy, I heard a line where he was talking about Tick. What was the relationship with you and Tick? Like, you knew Tick, or he said
Tick is my best friend. You understand what I'm saying? Tick is from Cashville. You understand?
Okay.
And Tick has always been amongst Jeezy. Jeezy is my homeboy, and, you know, at the same time, Jeezy always been in the circle. I've been always in Jeezy's circle. He's always been in my circle. And I've spoken to Jeezy. Jeezy was another one that I'm basically damn near forgot. But he was there throughout my time in the penitentiary and when I came out the penitentiary. But Jeezy's like a brother. So, you know, like I say, a lot of dudes that I be amongst, you know, I know what they gonna do. They gonna keep it 100. Jeezy one of them niggas, I know he gonna keep it 100 with a nigga. That's all he know. He's a real nigga. He's not an industry nigga. He's an industry nigga. You feel me? So I know how he gonna do it, but you know, like I say, man, for the most part, he's always been there. And rest in peace to my best friend, Tick, because,
wow.
You know, when he died, that shit affected me, it affected Jeezy. You know, Tick was a real Crip nigga, you understand what I'm saying? And he put a lot of real work in these streets, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of niggas, you know, just know him from an international level. You know, Tick used to stay with me a lot on that bus and shit, even when I was amongst the unit and shit, you know what I'm saying? So he missed. That's my nigga. But at the same time, I know he would want to see me out here doing my thing. So, you know, I keep his obituary on my dashboard. You understand what I'm saying?
Well,
every time I'm looking forward and looking out this motherfucking glass, I see his face and shit, and I'm like, this is what's keeping me moving forward. It's real niggas that played a part in my life that's not here no more, as well as the niggas in the penitentiary. You know, because I done time with a lot of dudes that'll never see the streets again, you understand? And I done time with a lot of dudes that's coming home. And just to see how a lot of dudes that would never see the streets again carry themselves far as still living life and not, you know, giving up on life and not even giving up on the chance of ever coming home, that was inspiration in itself, you understand, to see how these niggas are still holding up and staying strong. And, you know, so things like that, man, that just made me really respect, you know, your freedom a little bit more when you go through situations like I just did, you know what I'm saying? I wasn't in one of those happy prisons, you understand what
Damn.
I said? I was in that prison where nigga, you got 30 days to bring your paperwork to the yard. You don't have your motherfucking paperwork to the yard in 30 days, we're going to run you up top in your car, too. Your car is wherever you was from, my nigga. Like, I'm from Tennessee, so you're part of the Tennessee car. T.I. know about this shit. He know how this shit go. He done shit time. Shout out to him, you understand?
But wow.
At the same time, you know, that shit is serious, you know, when it comes to you know, snitches and shit like that, they can't walk the yard, you forbidden in prison. So that's a lesson for all you niggas that's telling or even got a situation in your mind where you're thinking about telling. Motherfucker, you're not safe in the streets and you're not safe in the penitentiary, you understand?
Yeah.
Because, you know, niggas don't play that shit, you understand?
Mm.
Just little different shit like that, you know. We were cooking out of trash cans, my nigga. You understand what I'm saying?
Holy
shit. Shit like that, you know, with a
what?
Stinger. You know what a stinger is? A stinger is something you stick in the trash can to heat up the grease and fry your wraps. You understand? Macros.
What?
Macros, nigga. You feel me? Jack Max, my nigga. That's what a nigga been fucking with for the last couple years, man.
Yo, man, that's crazy, man. Damn, man.
It's been real, man. You know, I just anything. I'm a chameleon, you understand?
Mm-hmm.
I just my environment. So, like I said, I do my time in the real way, and the motherfucker let you know that, you know what I mean? Shout out to my niggas that's locked up out there in Yazoo, Mississippi, you understand? From the low to the medium to the USP, you understand what I'm saying? Because, you know, I made a lot of shit happen. I made a lot of money in the penitentiary too, man.
You
feel what I'm saying?
Speaking of fire, before you go, is Kendrick Lamar on your radar? Like, you know, he's kind of like the new guy for every, you know, ill lyricist, because y'all consider you a lyrical motherfucker. Oh yeah,
to be honest, I listen to Kendrick Lamar album on the daily in the penitentiary. You understand? I'm a fan of Kendrick Lamar. I think he's a real dude. You understand? I think he's bringing that real shit. You know what I'm saying, to the game for us from a lyricist side, and he's not just focused on one type of thing. You know, Kendrick will bounce from here and bounce from there and bounce over here, but at the same time remain being who Kendrick is.
Mm.
And that's what you don't get out of a lot of artists. You got a lot of artists, I think, that, you know, they want to be this or be that. Now, Kendrick is being himself, and he's a real nigga, you understand, because I know a lot of niggas that turn around Kendrick, you understand?
Wow.
And, you know, at some point in time, man, I would want to work with Kendrick, you understand? Because I got a lot of respect for his music and shit. Like I say, I used to hit that motherfucking yard running that track, lifting weights and shit, listening to Kendrick shit, man.
That's crazy, man. Shit,
I probably had that nigga album before y'all had it. You know?
Yeah, I'm so happy you fucking called up today, man. Holy shit. We about to play this record again, then I'm going to do another Young Buck set. And you know, I got Ice Cube coming up here. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, man.
Yeah, we going to the west side now after this. You know, we in the south a little bit, you know what I'm saying? But we going to, you know, is there anything you want to shout out to Ice Cube before he comes up here?
Hell yeah, man. Hey, man, get me in a motherfucking movie. I need your big homie.
You know they doing Friday. Man. They doing the next Friday now. That'll be funny. You and
hey,
this.
Well, I think the movies is definitely going to be a good look for Buck. You understand what I'm saying? But I got the utmost respect for Ice Cube, you understand? I done had a chance to meet him, I think, maybe once or twice. But, you know, real recognized, real Cube is a legend to this hip-hop shit, man, and just the music in itself. I grew up listening to Cube, you understand, and just been a fan of Ice Cube for half my damn life, you understand what I'm saying? And, you know, at any point in time of ever being able to work with Cube, I don't think it's a motherfucker in this world would say no. You understand? Not to dealing with a Cube, but at the same time, make sure you give him my love, tell him I said much respect, and make sure you tell that nigga I said, yay, yay.
we're about to live dangerously again. This is the new joint right here. DJ Whoo Kid, Young Buck. Yeah, I'm about to
keep playing that motherfucker.
What?
Man. Matter of fact, see if I can get this motherfucker in rotation, O'Shea.
Oh, you know, it's a done deal.
I stay tuned in, you feel me?
It's a done deal, man. I'm politically connected, man. It's a done fucking deal, and the record is hot. So it's a done deal, man. We're going to get back.
I like that.
Going to get back into it. And then I'll play some of your freestyles, but you know I got to play some of your classic joints that we've done over the years.
Yeah, it's only right.
Yeah,
only right. A motherfucker asked me one time, yo, man, you got the G-Unit tattoo, you gonna cover it up? I said, no, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Fuck, I look like covering it up for, you know, at the same time, that was a
history.
Situation that meant something to
me.
A phase of my life that it came, and even though it went at the same time, at the time it got put on me, my nigga, it meant something. So, you know, shit like that. Other than that, though, make sure before I get out of here, man, make sure y'all follow me on Twitter
at
Young Buck, and make sure you follow my Instagram. I lost my fucking code and forgot that motherfucker. Started a new page. I need to get my shit up out there, man. Motherfuckers be thinking I ain't got no followers, so follow me on Instagram at Buckshot. That's BUCKSHOTZ. You understand? And all my booking information and all that shit is up there as far as features and show dates and all of that and shit. You know, if you want to get down and all that good shit, just hit me on the sites like that. I'm hands on with shit. Nigga, I might pick the phone up, motherfucker.
And what's hot is anybody that wants to hit me on my Twitter at DJ Whoo Kid, let me know what songs you want me to play from Young Buck before I go to the West Side. So, at DJ Whoo Kid.
These remixes killing them.
Yeah.
Killing niggas remixes. And real quick, Whoo Kid, my reason for doing the, you know, remixing a lot of these cast records that's all the way out, outside of me being a fan of the music or a fan of them, I'm basically, you know, putting together a quick mixtape. Well, no, let me be straight up with you. I don't even call my shit mixtapes. I'm calling the project that I'm doing with all these different remixes on all these dudes' shit, the Bricks tape.
Mm.
You understand? And I'm a release it here in the next couple of weeks. If you missed out on whatever remixes or you ain't catching the remixes that I got out there, you'll be able to go and download the Bricks tape real quick and be able to catch up, my nigga. But, you know, follow Buck, man. I got a lot of shit going on. Just stay tuned in, you understand? And I appreciate the love and all that, man. Real shit.
It's all good, man. I just love great music, man. Point blank, man.
Man.
Simple as that.
You know
man.
What? Don't ever change, motherfucker.
Pow.
Don't ever change.
What
Triple A? I got your back for life, nigga. I fuck with you.
Yeah, what Triple A? Shape 45.